Good afternoon, everyone. Good evening, everyone. So today we are going to discuss about reinforced earth, soil nailing, ground anchor. So these three are the topics that today we are going to discuss in ground improvement techniques. So I'm Chitra CJ taking you ground improvement techniques. So reinforced earth. So what do you mean by a reinforcement? A reinforcement is the technique in which we are incorporating the steel reinforcements or steel bars into a medium that is a less stable. So similarly, in this reinforced earth technique also, we are incorporating sheets, strips, nets of metal, synthetic fabrics or fiber reinforced plastic into the soil so that the stability of the soil increases. So that is a reinforced earth. So let's go in detail. Reinforced earth is a composite material formed by the association of frictional soil and tension resistant element in the form of sheets, stripes, nets of metal, synthetic fabrics or fiber reinforced plastic. Reinforced earth is a combination of earth and linear reinforcing strips that are capable of bearing large tensile stresses. Reinforced earth is also called as reinforced soil. So in the figure you can see how a tree resists its movement by inserting its roots way down to the earth. So here it's like a reinforcing of the soil itself. So this is what I'm talking. So here you can see that. Then reinforced soil structure, as in the figure you can see, are formed by compacted layers of soil 50 to 150 centimeter and reinforcing elements. So in this figure, you can see that there is a facing element. See here, this is the facing element of the soil. And here, these are the elements that we are inserting like reinforcement. These are the steel reinforcement that we are inserting into the soil. So this in the figure, you can see the reinforced fill reinforcements that we are inserting into the soil. The external face of the structure is protected by a facing, which may consist of shotcrete or wire mesh, geogrid, geotextile sheets, modular facing blocks, cast in situ of prefabricated panels or similar. So in this figure, this face can be either vertical or inclined. This you can see that. And we are inserting reinforcement through the soil in the case of a slop so that the stability of the slop increases. In this figure, you can see the road that is a cliff and it is reinforced with element that is steel elements. We are inserting steel strips or ladders into the soil. And this is the wall top out. And this is the facing. This is the reinforced backfill. So this is a figure showing the parts of soil reinforcement. Then types of reinforced soil wall facing. So that is the segmental precast concrete. Segmental, so in this we can see that we are dividing it into segments and we are inserting the reinforcing elements. Then the next is we are reinforcing it using geotextile or wrapped facing with shotcrete cover. So here we are the facing has been covered using geotextiles. Then modular block wall units. Then full height concrete panel. We are constructing a concrete panel as the facing. Then gabion facing. Gabion means these are the heavy gravels, heavy size gravels that has been packed in a wire mesh that are called the gabions. And we are using that gabions as the facing. Here you can see that. Then this is the tire facing units. So these are the various types of or various methods that we can adopt for reinforcement of soil. Then next is advantage of this reinforced soil structure. These are coherent and flexible to tolerate relatively large displacements, can use a wide range of backfill materials. That is a variety, even if the soil has a wide range of soil types, in various types of soil, we can use this method to increase stability, are easy to construct, are relatively resistant to seismic loading, that is for earthquakes, then can form aesthetically attractive retaining walls and slabs because of available of facing types. So I have discussed what are the various types of facings that are available in the case of reinforced structure. So we can use that for modifying the retaining walls and are often less costly than conventional retaining structures, especially for high steep slopes and high walls. Then next, general principle. So principle, how this actually works. So that we can see in reinforced soil structures, the reinforcing elements provide the structure. In reinforced soil structure, the reinforcing elements provide the structure with a component of tensile strength. So mainly the stability comes from the tensile strength of the element, the steel element that we are inserting. There is a tendency of the face of the wall to displace outward, so that we can see that during the construction or after the construction, the facing will have a tendency to move outward against the sloping. So when it moves upward, the tensile strength or the elements will have a friction between the soil. The outward movement of the soil is resisted by the reinforcing element that we are inserting. Because of the thin nature of this reinforcing element used in this type of structure, they can only provide tensile resistance. There is a transmission of force by friction between the grains and the reinforcement, introducing true cohesion to the whole mass. So that is how the stability comes. That is, when the facings move outward of the slope, the tensile action takes place and there is a friction between the grains and the element and introducing cohesion of the whole mass. Now, what are the reinforcing elements that we are using to stabilize the slope? First is metallic strips, polymeric strips, geotextile sheets, geogrids, metallic grids. So all these are the reinforcing elements that we can adopt in the case of reinforcing earth. Then let's discuss in detail what is strip reinforcing element. The mechanism of stress transfer between the reinforcement and the soil is essentially because of the friction that is developed between the surface of the reinforcing strip and the soil. The reinforced earth walls are currently constructed using galvanized steel strips. Epoxy coated steel strips have been developed and may offer higher resistance to corrosion. So the corrosion is the drawback of the steel strips that we are inserting. So for to resist that corrosion, we can apply epoxy coated steel. Non-metallic strips have been also developed, consisting of continuous glass fibers embedded in a protective coating of epoxy resins or of geosynthetic strips. So these are the types of strips that we can adopt to increase the stability of a slope. The next is a geotextile sheet. The mechanism of stress transfer, that is, I have already explained, the mechanism of stress transfer between the reinforcement and the soil is essentially due to the friction between the surface of the reinforcing sheet. A large variety of non-woven or woven polyester or polypropylene geotextiles. So a geotextile can be inserted into the soil along with the facing so that we can increase the stability of the slope. The most common facing are formed by wrapping the geotextile around the exposed soil. More popular mainly on account of their lower cost and greater corrosion resistance. So geotextile are most common now because of its low cost and greater corrosion resistance than that of the steel reinforcement. The mechanical characteristics of geosynthetics give rise to issues related to lower stiffness and their sustainability to significant creep. So that is the drawback, that is lower stiffness and susceptibility to significant creep. So what do you mean by creep? Creep is the flow of water from upstream to downstream. So that also is a problem when you use a geotextile sheet. Then in grid reinforcement, that is the next type of reinforcement that we can adopt. That is a geogrid and metallic grid. In grid reinforcement, polymeric or metallic elements are arranged in rectangular grid shape. So all of you know what is a geogrid. I have explained in previous classes what is a geogrid. So geogrid is an arrangement in which a rectangle openings will be there. It will be kind of net. Long side oriented parallel to the direction of movement between the reinforcement and the soil. So that is how we can arrange the geogrid. Long side will be oriented parallel to the direction of movement. Then the grid soil interaction involves both friction acting on the long side and passive bearing resistance of the short side. So when it get elongated, since it is in the shape of a rectangle, when one side get elongated, another side have a tendency to compress. So both this action will also contribute to the stability of the slope. They are made by polypropylene, polythene or PVC coated polyester. So you can see various types of facings, placing wall panels. So this is one kind of facing. Behind that we can see slopes, and here it is the top view, that is when reinforcement can be seen here, placing reinforcing strips, sheets or grids. See here, these are the reinforcing strips. These are the facing, placing wall panels. Then connecting reinforcement to wall panel. So once these are laid, we should properly connect the reinforcement with the facing. So these are the connections that are adopted to connect the reinforcement with the facing. Then backfilling. After that, we can backfill the facing using a suitable soil that is locally available. Then, the figure, you can see the sheet reinforcement and soil bags as the facing. So, it's a kind of facing in which we are using soil bags. And sheet reinforcement. See here, layer by layer, they are filling the backfill, and after filling one layer, they will be laying sheets over that. Again, soil will be laid. So like that, the stability of the slope can be adopted. Then grid reinforcement and concrete block facing. So this is another thing, that is we are adopting grid reinforcement. Here you can see that as a plain sheet with openings like net. So instead of sheet, we can use this grid reinforcement, and the facing is concrete block facing. Now next is grid reinforcement and gabion facing. These are the gabions you see. So I have explained what is a gabion. Gabion is a large gravel size that is incorporated in a wire mesh. So gabions can be arranged like a facings here. Then grid reinforcement and inclined facing. So in the case of inclined facing, they are adopting grid reinforcement. Then component of reinforced earth. So what are the main three components? Soil, skin and reinforcement. So skin means facing. Okay. Soil, facing and reinforcement are the three main components of reinforced earth. Arrangement of components in reinforced earth structure. The facing element. First will be the facing element. Then we can see the reinforcing element here, which is perpendicular to this facing element. And in between this reinforcing element, you can fill the backfill soil. Soil for reinforced earth. It should be granular, cohesionless material, not too much silt or clay, having partial size not more than 125 mm. So these are the best suitable soils for reinforced earth. Not more than 10% of the particles shall pass 75 micron sieve. The earth reinforcement coefficient of friction to be either higher than or equal to 0.4, and plasticity index should be less than 6. The soil must have a moisture content suitable for compaction. Then let's discuss about the skin. Skin is the facing element of the reinforced soil wall. These elements keep the reinforcement at the desired elevation in the reinforced soil wall and also protect the granular at the edge falling off. So what is the main purpose of a skin? Skin keeps the reinforcement at its desired elevation and also protect the soil from falling off. Made of either metal units or precast concrete panels. So we have seen what are the various types of facings. Then reinforcing material. The variety of materials can be used as reinforcing material like steel, concrete, glass fiber, wood, rubber, aluminium. Reinforcement may take from the form of strips, grids, anchors, sheet material, chains, planks, rock, vegetation, combination of these and other material forms. So we can vary the reinforcing material based on the site condition. Fasteners are used to make a connection between the facing and the reinforcement. So I have explained, we have to connect this face with the reinforcement. For that, we can use fasteners. Fasteners can be used to connect between the facing and the reinforcement element, usually in the form of hexagon headed screws and nuts and bolts. Reinforced earth abutment in a flyovers. You have seen like these structures. These are the reinforced earth abutments under flyover. Then next is reinforced soil retaining wall. Reinforced soil bridge abutment. So below this bridge, we can see that to avoid the settlement of the soil, we can increase the stability by inserting the element like reinforcing elements. Then design components. For design components, we have to check the skin, ties, foundation, settlement, overturning, and drainage. So these are the main design components for constructing a soil reinforcement structure. First, skin, calculate the lateral earth pressure based on the spacing of the ties and designed as thin shells. So skin is mainly designed based on the lateral earth pressure there and based on the spacing of the ties, designed as thin shells. Then tie design. There are two boundary conditions. The wall is perfectly flexible and frictionless. The wall will move laterally during the construction by sufficient amount to mobilize a state of active earth pressure. The tensile force increase from zero at the free end to maximum at the face of the wall. So it's like a water pressure behind a dam. Then the tensile force also increases linearly with the depth. As the depth increases, the tensile force also increases from zero to its maximum value. Then tension mode is the failure. Then factor of safety adopted is 1.5 to 2.5. Then foundation design. So foundation should be designed mainly to resist the bearing capacity failure. Bearing capacity of foundation soil must withstand the substantial settlement without damage to the structure. Sliding at the base of the structure is the next failure cause. Active earth pressure acts on the face wall and the friction at the bottom causes the sliding of the structure. So foundation should be designed to withstand resistance to bearing capacity failure, sliding at the base of the structure, and overturning. Overturning is the tilting of the upper portion of the wall, and if the reinforced strings are not long enough. Now next, settlement design. Not much design issues involved in a settlement design. Its limiting value depends upon the usage. Calculation is based on normal settlement of any structure. Settlement with the reinforced earth mass itself and the settlement of the foundation soil. So that is, the settlement should happen within the reinforced earth mass itself and settlement of the foundation soil. Now, drainage design. Drainage design is aimed to avoid interstitial pore pressure. Choose backfill soil with good drainage characteristic. Then provide boulders and column drain in case of array supporting embankment slope. So here the drainage design means the we should expect a flow of groundwater from the backfill. So to so we should not resist that flow. So to for that we should make sure that the soil that we are using for backfilling should have maximum drain permeability so that free flow of water occurs. Otherwise, the pore pressure will counteract the and it cause the failure of the structure. Then next is material selection. Soil must be able to develop friction. Backfill should be from non-organic soil such as sand, gravel, which are not affected by biological activities. So that is, it should not react with the element that we are using as the reinforcing element. Have good drainage. So I have explained why it is necessary to have a good drainage. Then primarily cohesionless soils are used. Then facing elements can be chosen from metal and concrete. So facing element means it is the vertical element that we can see. So that can be either metal or concrete. Based on durability and stability criteria, we are opting this. Then aesthetic can be equally important when used in urban area. So when we are using this reinforcing structure beneath the overbridge or highway, we can use aesthetically good facing elements. Then reinforcing stream, based on the electrochemical properties of the backfill, we can select the reinforcing strips. I have explained what are the various types of reinforcing strips available and can be chosen from metal to geosynthetics, etc., based on the durability criteria, and select fixtures accordingly used to connect strip to the facing element. Then, so next topic, so we have explained, so we have seen what is a reinforced soil. So reinforced soil is a structure in which we are inserting metal strips to increase the stability of the stock. Now next topic is soil element, soil nail. So it is similar to what we have discussed, that is a steel element is being inserted into the soil. Soil nailing is a technique to reinforce and strengthen the ground adjacent to an excavation by installing closely spaced steel bars called nails as construction proceeds from top to down. Soil nailing is potentially a solution of landslide problems as it is economical and also applicable in seismic zones. So in the case of earthquakes also, these methods can be adopted to increase the stability of that soil. It is an effective and economical method of constructing or retaining wall for excavation, support for hill cuts, bridge abutments, and highways. So these are the conditions in which we can use the soil nailing type. Nails are subjected to tension, compression, shear and bending moments. The grouted nail increases shear strength of overall soil mass. It can be used in wide soil types. History of soil nailing. Techniques came from New Australian tunneling method in 1960. Stabilization works in underground tunnel in Europe in 1970. The first recorded use of soil nailing in its modern form was in France in 1972. The United States first used soil nailing in 1976 for the support of 13.7 meter deep foundation excavation in dense silty sand. So these are the So here, this is the method by which we can insert soil nails. Once we are inserting the soil nails, bolting can be done to fix the spacing with the backfill. Soil nailing is a process of retaining soil by the incorporation of large number of reinforcement in the form of nails. Short length of stiff iron rods are driven into the soil, securing them at the facing wall. The mechanics of retention is based on the friction developing at the interface between the reinforcement and the soil. In order to protect the nail and to enhance interface friction, the nail surface can be pressure grouted with cement grout. So to increase the friction between the nail and the soil, we can incorporate cement grout. For this, a large number of nails are driven at closer spacing as in reinforced earth. Soil nailing can be temporary or permanent. Further nailing can be carried out with simpler and lighter equipment. Also, it is flexible. Then next is various types of soil nailing methods employed in the field are listed below, that is grouted soil nailing and driven nails. In this type of soil nailing, the holes are drilled in walls or slope face and the nails are inserted in the pre-drilled holes. Then the hole is filled with grouting material such as concrete, shotcrete, etc. Driven nails. Driven nail is used for temporary stabilization of soil slope. In this method, the nails are driven in the slope face during the excavation. This method is very fast but does not provide corrosion protection to the reinforcement steel or nails. So these are various types of soil nails. Then self-drilling soil nail. In this method, hollow bars are used. Hollow bars are drilled in the slope surface and grouters injected simultaneously during the drilling process. This method of soil nailing is faster than grouted nailing. This method provides more corrosion resistance to nails than driven nails. So self-drilling nail means it is the hollow bars that are used. Hollow bars are drilled into the slope surface and grouters injected simultaneously. So what do you mean by grout? Grout is a mixture of soil with the cement and that can be inserted into the hole to give more stabilization to the soil nail. Then jet grouted soil nail. In this method, jets are used for eroding the soil for creating the holes in the slope surface. Steel bars are then installed in this hole and grouted with concrete. It provides good corrosion protection for steel bars. Lodged soil nail. In this method for soil nailing, the steel bars are forced into the soil with very high speed using compressed air mechanism. The installation of soil nails are fast, but control over length of bar penetrating the grout is difficult. Then what are the various types of nails that are adopted? First is driven nail, grouted nail, corrosion protection nail, jet grouted nail, and launched nail. So let's see in detail what are the various types of nails. Advantages of soil nailing: it is not depend on heavy equipment, it is economical where the geometry of the wall is complex, less impact on nearby properties. So that is, when we are using the soil nailing technique, when compared to any other ground improvement technique, it has a less impact on the nearby buildings. The need for corrosion protection stands reduced. Construction can be carried out with little disturbance to the environment in terms of noise and vibration. Then retaining walls are secured laterally into the soil, eliminating piles and foundation footers. Grouting only once is required. So what is grouting? Grouting is the technique in which we are inserting the soil nail with the cement. Then technique is flexible and easily modified, creates less noise and traffic obstructions. Then allow in situ strengthening on existing slab surface. So in this technique, we are just inserting the nails into the soil and bolting it with the facing. So there is no disturbance to the adjacent structures. Allow in situ strengthening on existing slab surface. Allow excellent working space in front of excavation face, and can be used for strengthening on either natural slab or man-made cut slabs. So what we are doing in soil nailing is, we are just inserting the soil elements of short length into it by tamping it over the surface and then bolting it with the facing elements. Disadvantage of soil nailing: not well suited where large amount of groundwater seeps into the excavation. Permanent soil nail walls require permanent underground basement, less suitable for coarse grain soil and soft clay soil, which have short self-support time and soil prone to creeping. Suitable only for excavation above the groundwater, nail encroachment to retained ground rendering unusable underground space. Generally, large lateral soil strain during the removal of large support and ground support cracking may occur. So all these are the main disadvantages. Then design consideration. So when you design a soil nailing technique, the main criteria that you should consider is the stability and serviceability. What do you mean by stability? Stability of a soil nail throughout the design should be assessed. The design of a soil nail system should ensure that there is an adequate safety margin against all the preserved potential mode of failure. Then serviceability. The performance of soil nail system should not exceed a state at which movement of the system affects its appearance or the efficient use of nearby structures. Then durability. The environment condition should be investigated at the design stage to less assess their significance in relation to the durability of soil nails. Economic consideration: the construction cost of a soil nail system depends on material cost, construction method, temporary works requirements, buildability, and environmental consideration. Construction of a soil nail system may disturb the ground ecosystem, so reduce noise and pollution during the construction and cause visual impact to the existing environment. And what are the main applications of soil nailing? Is landslide remediation, railway embankments, roadway widening under existing bridge, stabilizing of existing retaining walls, highway embankments and cuttings. Then what are the applications of soil nailing? It can be used in rail roads, highway cut slots, excavation, retaining structure in urban areas, etc. Then using tunnel in tunnels also, stabilizing steep cuttings. Then construction sequence, during the initial excavation, step one, see here construction sequence is, first we are having a steep slope here, and we can drill holes and insert the soil nails here. In this you can see they are drilling holes and inserting this nails into the soil. Then these soil nails are bolted to the facing. Then grouting can be done to fix the soil nail with the facing. Then place reinforcement and drainage. Repeat the steps to get the layer subsequent of one over the another. Then ground anchors. An earth anchor is a device designed to support structures. An earth anchor is a device designed to support structures most commonly used in geotechnical and construction applications, also known as percussion-driven earth anchor. So what next topic is ground anchors. An earth anchor is a device designed to support the structure most commonly used in geotechnical and construction application, also known as percussion-driven earth anchor or mechanical anchor. So let's see what is a ground anchor. Ground anchors provide solution to problems of foundation in tension. So these are all similar to that of reinforced earth method, in which we are inserting this elements and to increase the stability. So what are the uses of ground anchor? They are used to tie back slurry walls, rehabilitating existing retaining wall, resist uplift in the dams, prevent flotation of groundwater structure, resist uplift in the slender structures, prevent rock fall in road cuts, provide preloading to a foundation, prevent heave due to swelling, tie down a pipeline and its foundation. So in the figure you can see they are inserting a tube, that is anchor, and through this they can emit the grout. Okay, so grout anchors and its components, it will be having an anchor head, a tendon. So this is the anchor head. So this is the anchor head, tendon, fixed anchor, pre-stressing. The anchor is the combined system of anchor head, bearing plate, trumpet, that is capable of transmitting the pre-stressing force from the pre-stressing steel to the ground surface or to the supporting structure. So let's see the figure and it will be more clear for you. There are three main ground anchor types that are currently used. First is straight shaft gravity grouted ground anchor, straight shaft pressure grouted ground anchors, post grouted ground anchors, and under rimmed anchor. Type A, type B, type C, and type D. Type A, say straight shaft gravity grouted, then straight shaft pressure grouted, then post grouted, then underrimmed. So here you can see there will be a spreading of the concrete and the plate anchor. See, when this is inserted, there will be a plate trench excavation and multi-helix screw anchor. See, this will resist the uplifting of an element when we are attaching this to a building. Then grout anchor, here a concrete mesh will be there and a steel outward like this, and this steel rod can be attached to a structure. Then this is the under ring anchor. Straight shaft gravity grout anchors are typically installed in rock and stiff to hard cohesive soil deposit. Use either rotatory drill or hollow steam auger methods. They are used to grout the anchor in a straight shaft borehole. Borehole may be cased or uncased depending on the stability of the borehole. Straight shaft pressure most suitable for coarse granular soil and weak fissured rock. This anchor type is also used in fine grain cautionless soil. Grout is injected into the bond zone under pressures greater than 0.35 megapascal. The borehole is typically drilled using a hollow stem auger using rotary techniques with drill casing. Then next is post grouted ground anchors. So in the under-reamed anchors, you can see in the figure, under-reamed anchor, here there will be a projection itself from the steel rod that will resist the uplifting of the steel hole or the buildings that is attached to it. Thank you.